This is Jordan Tao with JT News. Let's just get caught up for the day, and then we'll get into some better news as the day goes on. We got Christian Rock. She says, I can't wait for my baby daddy to be out. Y'all just mad I cream over his D. Pause, okay? So stop, okay? We don't need to know that, okay? And plus, you're a mess, bro. You, Blueface is entertaining. He's kind of messy. But, like, Christian Rock is just does whatever. Whatever she got to do to make a dollar right now. You know, it's just. And she lies. She doesn't even understand what's going on. She's like, I make like $1 million a week on Snapchat. No, you don't. If Aiden Ross isn't making $1 million a week on Snapchat, you're not. Okay. Mr. Beast doesn't even make $1 million a week on Snapchat. Okay. Stop. Stop. You do not have even 20% of what those guys have. As far as a fan base. Black Youngst, if Shade Room and everybody stopped posting Christian Rock, you would forget. You would just forget. Trust me. Black Youngster, aka CMG Junkie. Okay. So he's a problem. He took it upon himself at CIAA, I believe, to go after Young Dolph with his friends to try to prove some loyalty to Gotti. If you notice, as time went on, Yo Gotti distanced himself from Black Youngster, okay? Music wasn't hitting. He had newer artists. And, you know, he kind of phased him out slowly over the years. You didn't hear about it. He makes appearances every once in a while and does his little, you know, crackhead dance. You know, that's his gimmick. It's nothing talented about this guy at all. He was entertaining for a little while, but this is old, okay? You're in your 30s now. Grow up, bro, okay? Then we got Yo Gotti. He makes his first public appearance wearing a bulletproof vest under his shirt at a 42 Doug concert. He feels like his life is in danger. He should feel like his life is in danger. Black Youngster and him are prime targets right now. Because, and, you know, it's kind of sad because I really do believe Big Juk had a lot to do with the violence going on towards Pre and back and forth and put the battery in a lot of people's back. Big Juk is what Yo Gotti raps about. Now, I'm not saying Yo Gotti didn't do anything. I've seen Yo Gotti in person have heart, okay? So I'm not saying by any means he's not street. I'm just saying Big Juk was a lot more street. That's all, like 10 times Yo Gotti, okay? 10 times, okay? That doesn't take anything away from Yo Gotti. Yo Gotti, I'll never say that Yo Gotti wasn't from the streets, and I've seen it with my own two eyes. So that's, you know, just like Gucci Man. You can't say that he didn't put it all on the line and go around the hoods and everything. Like, it's, you can't refute that. Okay, you just can't. It is what it is. Now, Plaz, you could probably say, nah, that guy was pretty fake. It's funny, though. There's a lot of rappers that rap after their brothers. That's what Plaz did, too. That's what The Game did. You know, they rap, their brother does something, and they emulate it in their raps. There's a lot of instances of that with rappers. This is Muwop, the old Block 6 that got found guilty. I mean, you guys are reckless, man. Putting stuff on social media, you give the feds their case, you know. Look what he wrote in his shoe, Flash Duck. It was like subliminal messaging to take him out, you know. I'm lost for words. It's so dumb, so stupid. It's crazy. It's like, this was cool to talk about taking people out. It's like, nah. So Kid Cudi apologized to Lupe Fiasco. Lupe Fiasco says, hey, that's not enough, buddy. Okay? You need a phone to call me. We need to talk. Kid Cudi disrespected Lupe a while back. He kind of like tried to play him. Lupe always had a good energy. Lupe does always has a good energy unless you try to play him. Okay? Lupe is somebody, I've met him before. He's just as he is. Nice guy. But don't cross him because you're not going to play with him either. You know, like, he's nice until you disrespect him. And Kid Cudi tried to play him online when he was charging for verses. Oh, what you can do with this money, bro? You know, and then, you know, Kid Cudi had his own insecurities about working at Bape for some reason. I don't know why that would be an insecurity. I respect anybody that has a job before as they're working on their passion, you know. And so does Lupe. Drake disses Mos Def, basically calls him a crackhead. Goes Bohemian Bucket. Okay, buddy. Drake, stop. Drake, nobody dissed you and said you were trash or anything. He just said you're not just hip-hop. You're more than that. You're pop. There's nothing wrong with that. Anyways, this is Jordan Tao with JT News. I'm going to have some more news shortly. This is Jordan Tao. I'm sorry. I already said that. Peace.